Wow. You know, you can't reach a position like this without a lot of help. And I'd like to thank a few people before we get started. First of all, I'd like to thank our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ for the tender mercies that He's shown our family. I'd also like to give a heartfelt thanks to the co-founders of this company. You know, it's interesting, our first real convention was 10 years ago at the 10-year anniversary of ACN. And it was interesting, in Utah and Idaho, we were still just a long-distance company. And look at what's happened in the last 10 years in this company, what's taking place and what's going to take place. And we can't give enough credit to the founders of this company for their integrity, their vision, their steadfastness, and all the things that they've done. They've done a phenomenal job in this industry, in any industry. So we, all of us in this room, should be totally thankful for what they've done and the opportunity they've given us. It's absolutely phenomenal. We couldn't be happier with having the opportunity to be in this organization and work with these fine men. I'd also like to thank my family. My kids wouldn't come up on the stage with us today. That's okay, but I appreciate Megan and Ryan and Spencer for the good children they were and for the adults they've become. And I appreciate our other children that aren't here that take another pass, done the same thing. I'd like to give a special thanks to Terry and Rhonda. Terry's been a great friend for the last 40 years and appreciate all his help and support as well. Lastly, but not least, to be the team and organization we've been fortunate to work with in ACN over the last 10 years. A lot of people aren't here, a lot of people are, but it's been an honor and privilege to work with you guys over this time. And I want everybody to know that heartfelt thanks that Martha and I have for you all and the efforts you make in this business. We have some of the greatest reps, IBOs in the company, in our organization, in the merchant organization, and we have the finest people in our organization, appreciate it very, very much. I'd also like to thank some of the folks that have been an example to us throughout the years, and I can't name a lot of names, but certainly the guys that have been in ACN for a long time, and we've talked to most of them individually. They've been a great example for us and showed us how to do the business. The guys in the Empire, the group that we came up through, those guys were phenomenal to show us how to do the business. So we really appreciate these people as well. The Canadians are always great to look at. They're the opponents, the Canadians. They always do it well. At any rate, we appreciate that. There's two people, though, I'd like to mention their names for because they really showed us how to do the business. The first is Mr. Larry Raskin. Larry, Spencer saw this business in August of 2002 in Cincinnati, and he almost walked out of the arena when Larry's getting ready to speak. And had Larry not been on his game in 2002, I look out there and I see a lot of people might not be sitting here today had Spencer left that arena and not been inspired by what Larry had to say. It's one of these close-run things, I guess, but the point is Spencer turned around and went back in and caught the vision of ACN. It was due to what Larry was saying and how he was saying it, the passion that he had. In addition to that, he came out to our marketplace many times during the first years of our time in the business and really showed us how to do the business. So we have a tremendous amount of thanks and gratitude to him. The other guy we'd like to thank is Mr. Jeff Weber in the Empire. He was Spencer's mentor and basically the guy that once again showed us how to do the business. Without those two individuals and the inspiration of all the other leaders in this company, we wouldn't be standing here today. So thank you very much for all that you've done for us. I'd like to just tell our story very quickly. About 10 and a half years ago, Martha and I were sitting at our kitchen table assessing our lives. You know, we've been working 35 years in three careers. I'd spent a career in the Army. After that, I was a general contractor in Western Washington and over in the Boise, Idaho area after I retired. And Martha was a registered nurse, and she started working in Boise with a new doctor. They came together and started working in an OBGYN clinic and built a big practice up over 8 years. Yeah, we were sitting there 10 and a half years ago, realized we'd spent 35 years in traditional type business, and we weren't where we needed to be financially. And I don't know about you all, we have a lot of young people in this auditorium today, so maybe this is a cautionary tale for you, I'm not sure. For the older people, I think you can understand where we were coming from. We didn't really know what to do, and it's interesting, as we look at our lives, our future is often dictated by what our present and past has been. And we were sitting there thinking, what are we going to do? We're not where we need to be. We're not sure we want to do what we want to do or what we've been doing, because it wasn't taking us where we needed to go, and we didn't know what to do. But our thought process was still kind of in the pattern of what we've been used to. Now, I could have started building houses at a larger scale. I was a very small-time general contractor. I could have built houses at a larger scale and borrowed some more money and built a lot of houses, and I would have been pretty good till about 2008, and then we would have lost our shirts. Martha could have gone back to school and become a doctor. She's a very smart woman. Yeah, it would have been about 10 years. She still would have been in school today, and the lifestyle is absolutely awful. We're trying to go through the medical profession. Those that are in the house that are doctors understand that. We have one of our daughters is a doctor, so we understand how bad that lifestyle is. So we really didn't know what to do. We were kind of stuck. I was 56 years old at the time. I wasn't going to be hired by anybody. We had to come up with something different. We had to look at our future in a very different way. Well, in August of 2002, I got a phone call from my son. He was supposed to be going to college and playing baseball. And he called me up and says, "Hey, Dad, I got this great business where you can become millionaires." And I kind of looked at the phone. You know, if anybody has grown children, you get a call like that, you're a little bit skeptical, particularly when your son hasn't really done much business stuff, you know? And at any rate, little did we know. And so we looked at what Spencer was doing. And I'm going to say this about what Spencer was doing. He got into ACN, saw the vision, and took off and really ran with it. And I have to say that probably had he not done that, I'm not sure we'd still be standing here today either. And so maybe this is something we ought to think about. We have an obligation when we join ACN to get out here and give it our best shot, whatever time we can give it. Because all the people around us are really counting on us. And had Spencer not done that, it might be a whole different story here, but he did. He started working real hard at ACN, started making twice as much money as Martha and I were making, and we decided, well, this is something maybe we ought to do. And this is something that was totally radical and different than what we'd ever been used to. And so basically we got started at ACN, and it's been a tremendous business. And I'd like to just say a little bit about that. We are not superstars in this business. We're kind of like plotters, I guess, would be the best way to describe us. I was asking Martha one time, I was making a comment to Martha one time. I said, "Martha, we've never been in the top 10, have we?" And she got all indignant and said, "Yeah, we've been in the top 10 one quarter." I said, "Well, Martha, we've only been doing this 40 quarters, you know. I'm not sure that's really burning this thing up." Now, I want to say to everybody out here, you have permission to be in the top 10 if you want to be. But if you're not, understand, you can make a tremendous business and have a tremendous change of lifestyle with ACN. So just keep that in mind, folks, when you're doing this opportunity, because it's a tremendous opportunity. You give a consistent effort, you're going to do very, very well. And I'd just like to say at the end of our story, before I turn it over to my better half, is that in 3.5 years, we got to where we wanted to be financially because of ACN. Now think about that, 35 years in conventional business, 3.5 years in ACN. Not a bad choice, right, folks? Now, at this time, I'd like to turn the rest of the time over to a real kick-ass IBO, my better half for 38 years, the real driving force behind our business. I'm going to let everybody understand she's the driving force behind our business, and she's going to close this thing out. So I'd like to have Senior Vice President Martha Hunt.
But you know what? Jim and I decided that we were going to do whatever it took to make ACN work. One of my great heroes, Mr. Tony Kupas, said that that's the sign of a leader. They do whatever it takes to make ACN work. So we did. But what does it take to make ACN work? I'm going to tell you just a few things, just a couple things. Number one, you guys, you got to be tough. You got to be tough. I brought a great work ethic into this business, but man, I had to toughen up. Some of you in this room are just like me. You're not emotionally very tough. I was a big baby. Spencer even took me aside one time and he said, "Mom, you sound like a country mouse." And then he said, "People follow strength, not weakness." He was trying to give me a hint. He even told me what a strong person sounded like. He said, "Remember in the mornings on Saturday morning, and we said you had to clean the house, we had to clean the house before we could go do our stuff and play and have fun?" He said, "Use that tone of voice when you talk to people." So we have to be tough. Ladies and gentlemen, you have to sacrifice. No pain, no gain. There's going to be a lot of sacrifices along the way. If you want what you want, if you want something great, you're going to have to sacrifice. Jim and I have done crazy, crazy things to sacrifice. I want you to know that I know every public restroom between Utah and Idaho. And now I know them all on Southwest Airlines. We've slept on lots of couches. We've been in lots of people's homes. We've done a lot of crazy things. We've divided and conquered. A lot of people will say to me, where's Jim? Why isn't he here? Well, you know what? If you divide and conquer, you get more done. And lots of times one of us was with the family and the other was with the ACN family. But we just did whatever it took. One of the things I've enjoyed the most about this business is that God put into my path a way for me to learn what faith was. We picked faith instead of fear. I had so much fear when I started ACN. I even confessed to Mr. Greg Provenzano how terrible that my fear was when I started in this business. But this is what we did. Actually, this is what I did. I can speak for myself. I walked up to the fear and I faced it and I looked straight on and I felt the fear and I did it anyway. I want to tell you a little story, or a little promise. Just like the fervent prayer that I asked God when I was asking Him what to do about our financial future, He hears and answers your prayers when you pray and ask Him to help you in your daily path in ACN. I prayed to get a customer. I prayed to talk in front of people. I'm so glad that God taught me what faith was with this great company. So, ladies and gentlemen, what future do you want? Do you want the one that you came into this arena with on Friday? Or like Jim and I, do you want the future that ACN can give to you? God bless.